I think where we're at in the biotechnology industry right now is a little bit where the semiconductor industry was 20 or 30 years ago.
I think biotechnology can be a way to combat climate change. I'm using clean technology to reduce things like greenhouse gases.
Achieving these biotechnology moonshots really depends on having a well-trained group of students and scientists and engineers coming out. And our students from the Master of Biotechnology program will play important roles both in developing the research as well as putting it into practice in terms of scale-up and commercialization.
Our program teaches students not just the technical skills, but also the intangibles. We teach students how to communicate, how to collaborate, how to think critically, and how to think creatively. We have a number of workshops throughout the year that help students to understand the team dynamics, to help them work together, to help them achieve good results.
The professional development course is one of our key initiatives for the Master of Biotechnology program. My job is to make sure that the students have everything that they need so that when they're looking for full-time positions, that they're prepared and they're ready. MBP has a lot of relationships with companies, so they can always think of us if they have an internship or an entry-level position in mind.
The resources available at MBP and Northwestern really made finding an internship and job so much easier. I was a business technology analyst at Deloitte. They are hiring specifically students in the life sciences. This internship is actually very much focused to people in our kind of program. So a lot of my peers got internships at Eli Lilly, Cook Pharmica, and other biotech companies.
I came in MBP program as an engineer with a very small focus on what's possible with biotechnology. I work at AbbVie. I get to ask and try to answer some of the most challenging questions today.
We have tremendous knowledge right now about how biology works. We have tools and systems and technologies that allow us to address biological systems. And I think the merger between technology and biology right now is really going to lead to a biological revolution.